you are not your you mother, I will kill you. But now I have no relation with you. And then he called Maharaj Maharshi Vasishtha and all other rich persons of wealthy persons of Ayodhya, and he went to Chitrapu to meet his brother and to tell him that you should return back and be the king of Ayodhya. Three mothers also went there. Whole military also went there. And the paraphernalia of Abhishek for Ramchandra also it was taken. When they reached there in the night, Bharat took rest with whole army and mothers. In the night he went to Mother Kausalya and he told Mother Kausalya, there is my request that if you will tell Ram to return back to Ayodhya and to be king, he cannot refuse. He must come. You should tell him. He told, how can I tell? Because I am am I wrong? No, you are not wrong. You are ocean of love and affection. But Ram, like Himalaya, in Dharma, so he can dive in your love and affection ocean, but he will not move an inch here and there. So how I can tell? To Vasishtha Maharaj, Gurudev, he told same thing and he answered same thing. And then he returned back. Then at that time Maharaj Janak of Sita Devi, he was there, he came there. A big council was there. One side Sri Ramchandra, Lakshman, Sita, and other side Ayodhya, the inhabitants of Ayodhya, all were sitting, and one side all the rishis and maharshis were there, and in the middle Maharaj Janak was there sitting. Maharaj Vasishtha told, you know, wife of Maharaj Dasarath, the nauka, boat of Ayodhya is about to be. So you have reached here. You are their guru and father, like father also. You should save the Ayodhya. Then Maharaj Janak sought towards Sri Ramchandra. Will you obey my order? What I will decide? Certainly, because you are like my father and also my guru. And then he sought towards Bharat and asked, will you obey me? Oh, certainly, I must obey. Then he told, he meditated Bhagavan Shankar, his Gurudev, and then he began to tell. Here, the love of affection of Bharat has owned, and Ramchandra is defeated. So, but all thought that, oh, if Bharat is owned, then he will go to Ayodhya and take the position of king. But in the meantime, Maharaj Janak told, though you have owned and Sri Ramchandra is defeated, but yet love and affection, Prem has his own riti niti, rules and regulations. You should go to Ram, he is your Ishtadev, and ask him how he will be pleased, and do according that. Then Partha stood up and fell on the feet of Maharaj Janak that you are Guru. Up till now I was thinking that if Ram will go, I will be very happy. All inhabitants of Ayodhya will be happy, Mathas will be happy. But I never thought that how Ram will be pleased. Now I think. And he went and did pranam to Ram and asked, my dear brother, how you will be happy? I will follow your order. Then Ramchandra told, oh, as Maharaj Janak has told, I am defeated, so really I am defeated. Now I am taking the kingdom of Ayodhya and out I am king. But I want that father promise also be fulfilled. So for 14 years you like my representative, you should return back to Ayodhya, and from like my representative, you should look after kingdom. Then Bhart took his sandal on his head and returned. So our happiness is not bhakti, pure bhakti. Like Maharaj Dhruva, in 6 months only, he meditated on Narayan. And after that he took darshan of Narayan. But what Narayan gave him? 36,000 years of universe. So his bhakti is not pure. So we should have no worldly desire. We should have desire to fulfill the desire of Krishna. This is pure. By the gradation of this bhakti, Srila Sanatana Goswami had told there are 5 kinds of devotees. Jnani Bhakta. Then Shuddha Bhakta. Then pure Bhakta. Then Prematur Bhakta, Prepra Bhakta, and Prematur Bhakta. Prahlad Maharaj is Jnani Bhakta. He was not Jnani, but Jnani Bhakta. Those who think that Aham Brahmasmi, I am Himself Brahma, all are Brahma. Pragyanam Brahma, Tattam Asi, So Aham. That is against Bhakti. So, we should not follow this. But here, Jnani Bhakta means he always used to see everywhere his Ishtadev, Krishna. And in everyone heart he used to see his Ishtadev. And in Ishtadev he used to see all living entity, that is Jnani Bhakta. Prahlad Maharaj, he knew that he is Supreme Lord. He has no thirst or appetite. He cannot feed him. He never become tired. He cannot message. He cannot do any service. But by all the senses we should serve, so he is called Jnani Bhakta. He cannot do any personal service to Supreme Lord. And then, you know, Ambarish Maharaj, by 11 senses, he gives to serve Krishna. And his kingdom ruled by brahmins. And then, more superior, Premi Bhakta Hanuman, always serving day and night. But he cannot give his remnant to Ramchandra, Supreme Lord. He cannot embrace Ramchandra. More superior, Pandav, Arjun used to eat in one plate, sleeping on the same bed. In this way, Krishna has given marriage to his sister, Subhadra. In Mahabharata battle, he became charioteer and he followed the order of Arjun. Oh, take my chariot in the middle of both armies. He did. But when he saw Vishwaroop, lax hands, so many mouths, everything, and he saw that all both army in the teeth of about to die. Then he began to tell, I have done wrong offenses. I have told you Shaka, I have ordered you. You became my charioteer. From now I will let you. Please excuse me. More than that, Uddhav, his Shaka, his
minister,
Prime Minister.
His
Prime Minister and so many things. Shaka, Commander in Chief, everything was. But he also cannot give his remnant to Krishna. He takes him like his supreme master. And he what did? His praying. Seeing the high class of devotion of gopi. Asa maho charada reed yusam ham syam vrindavane kimam gulmalo kausadina das tus tajam svajan arja patan chahitva bhede mukanda padme suti vivekya. Still now, the sutis, the Vedas, they are searching Krishna, but still not they have taken darshan. But gopis has kept Krishna in their hand. So I want to be in bread of cross in Vrindavan. And there gopis will come and their foot dust will be on my head and my life will be successful. Bande Nanda Prajestrina. I am praying the dust of any gopis. One dust. So one dust from whom? Oh, Vandi Radhi. Because in separation group, they have told so many Harikatha, Bhramar Geet, Gopi Geet and Venu Geet. So many things. Their love and affection is all unparalleled. So Krishna has himself told, Napare ham nirvatya sanjujan. Oh gopis, I cannot pity you in having a life of Brahma. I cannot. But you are sadhu yourself. You can. Excuse me. And repay me, but I will always
debtor to you.
And among them, Paradika, Anyaradito Nunam Bhagavan Hari Vishwara, Jagru Vihaya Govinda, Jan As. Here he is telling that, oh, Radhika, this lady who has done with Krishna in Nirjar Pradesh, in solitary place, she is most dear to Krishna, because Krishna has taken alone her husband. So Srimati Radhika is supreme lover of Krishna, most beloved of Krishna. So in this life, we must have a goal. Without goal, life of goal, we are like animals. The first step should be goal, to be the best servant of such a Radhika. Then we can have some love and affection for Radha and Krishna Deva. This is aim and object of our bhajan, our life. And what is the process to attend? Then, ādau sattha tato sādhu sangha. Tato bhajana kriyāto anarthanya bhakti tato nishtha ruchis, then āsakti, then bhav and everything. Beginning from there. And for this, you will have to do upadeshamrita, follow upadeshamrita. The nectar of Srila Rupa Goswami, all this. So in briefly, I have told you, your life should be successful. You should try to make your aim and objective of life there, and then follow practicing. Go Premanande.
Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Bo, Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Bo.
So, like, thanks to you.